Hi everyone, this is UBot Buddy, and I'm here to show you a video. And what I'm going to do today is, if you're in UBot, then you're familiar with one of the commands called page scrape. And so if you come up here, and let's go down here to the browser functions. What I'm referring to is this one right here. And I heard that there are some questions as to how to properly use that particular function. And so what I wanted to do is kind of show an example of how I would accomplish the task using Regex. And so here you can see this is my particular test website that I play with, that I created for myself. But if I come up here and just grab this, and I'm going to Control C and copy it, and I'm going to go to an area, I'm going to go to a web page where I can play with this particular text here and see if I can come up with an expression to use in my filter when I try to scrape it. And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to paste up here for my expression. Now, as you can see, it's not finding any matches. And so what I've got to do is I've got to set up the delimiter on certain characters so the regex will process it. And that's what I'm doing with the backslashes here. And now you can see that it has selected this text. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to put a parentheses around the text that I ultimately want to have in my data. And you can see here, this is where it shows up for the matched group. Now, going back to my web page, let's see, it's in UBot, wasn't it? I've got more than one in here. So if you see here, I can grab this text. I'm going to copy it. I'm going to go back to the Regex website. And I'm just going to paste this new version in here. And you can see it didn't work. So what I have up here in my expression just doesn't match up with this. And we all know it's because of this right here, this text. And so if I put in a wild card and just do that, here it is. Now this is a very simple regex expression, and I do have it in the parentheses here, and you know, you really don't need the parentheses. I just like it personally. So if I copy this and save this for later, then what I can do is I can go back to my UBot and I can actually scrape this. Now here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a regular set command here, and I'm just going to call it var for now. And I want to do a scrape. Now I can paste it in here, but I don't want to do that just yet. So what I want to do is I'm going to click on the selector, and then I'm going to come up here, and you can see that this is everything as far as Atlanta is in Georgia. That is what I'm targeting here. And so what I want to do to use the regex is I'm going to switch over to inner text. Then I'm going to click down here and I'm going to click on regular expression. Then I'm going to come down here. And I am going to paste. Well, let's just go ahead and paste the whole expression in here. And it's based on inner text. I'm going to click OK. And I'm going to say inner text here. I'm going to click OK. OK. And then let's bring up the debugger. I'm just going to run it. And you can see here it came up with a lot of items. And the reason it came up with a lot of items is because of this right here. It took this and it grabbed everything, including this over here, and it just built one big list. Now I want to reduce this. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back in here and I'm going to put in tag name equals. I'm going to go P, close that with the parentheses, and then I'm going to put and. Now the reason I'm doing that, and let me go and click OK here, I'm going to re-edit this. If I click the selector and come over here again and click this, now you see what I clicked on here, but you see the P here. Now the tag name that I put in is P for paragraph. And so what I'm saying here is anything with a tag of P for paragraph and the inner text is this regex expression, I want the inner text from that. Now, if I come up here to debugger, if I run it again, you can see I got everything on this page, which is exactly what I wanted. Now, how do I get these other items separated? So what I have to do at this point is I need to count all of these. And so let's go ahead and change one thing, make it a little better programming here. How many to scrape? So let's run it again. Okay, that still works, even though I changed the variable name. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to add another set command. I'm going to change the how many to scrape. But this time, what I'm going to do is I'm going to, let's see, let's close this. I'm going to text. I want to know how many I have here. So I'm going to use text length. All right, and I'm going to come up here and replace. And in my variables, I'm going to take how many to scrape. I'm going to put that here. I'm going to take new line. I'm going to put that here, and I'm going to replace it with nothing. And somewhere, nothing got added, so we're going to have to catch that. So let's put nothing here. We'll click OK. Okay, there's nothing. So let's come up here and delete that. And what I'm going to do is it's going to reduce all of the P's, the paragraphs, onto one line, okay? And then it's going to give us a count. So let's go over here and let's run it again. And it shows 1,075. Well, we don't need 1,075. And so what I've got to do here is I've got to scrape the attribute this time and say, okay, instead of inner text, let's go with tag name. Now, here's a little trick you won't find in on the wiki. If you come up here and look for an attribute to scrape, you won't see tag name, but you can add it. So we click OK. Now we bring up our debugger again, and we run it, and we got 15. Now if you come back over here and count each one of these, there are 15. All right, so now we have our count. So what we want to do at this point is we're going to create a loop. So I'm going to come up here and put a set, and I'm going to call it index. And I'm going to make it a -1. And then we're going to add a loop. And we're going to loop it with this many, with this count that appeared here. So we're going to come down here to variables, how many to scrape. And we're going to come up here to flow, go to data, increment our index. And the reason I started with a -1 is I wanted to make sure when the loop started, I was going to be at 0. So when this increments to 1 by 1, it's going to start out at 0. Now, what I'm going to do now is let's get a set. And we're going to do a scrape. Let's go ahead and recreate our var. This is a temporary variable that I'm going to use. I'm going to go with scraper functions. I'm going to go with scrape attribute. This time, I want to isolate this line right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use element offset because I'm going to focus on this one line. Okay, and so all I have to do at this point is come back up here, copy this, come in here, paste it, and then for the offset, I'm going to put index. The attribute that I'm going to grab here is it's going to be inner text, okay? So let's set that up to inner text. And we're going to click OK. Now, according to our index has not been set, so let's go ahead and run that once. There's our -1. Let's run it again at 0. And we're just going to run this one time, and you'll see it grabbed Atlanta is in Georgia. Let's close this, and you can see there it is. And so that works perfectly, okay? That's exactly what I want. Now at this point, we're done with that. So what I'm going to do So I'm going to come up here and grab the set again. I'm going to set it to var. This time I'm going to go into my text functions. I'm going to grab replace. And I'm going to set this to, let's see here, let me go back to here. And the first thing I'm going to use is the write text here. I'm just going to copy that. What I want to do is I want to search for that, okay? And I want to replace it with nothing. All right. Now, I'm going to take another replace. I'm going to put it right here. This time, I'm going to go back. I'm going to get the left text. Copy that. I'm going to search for that. And I'm going to replace it with nothing. Now what I'm going to put here is I'm going to put var. I'm going to click OK. 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 Now let's open up our debugger. This is what we have. This is the replace. I'm going to run it, and now I'm left with what was between left side of text and right side of text. So I'm done with that. So what I'm going to do at this point is I want to add this to a list. And so I'm going to come over here, and since this is one item, we're going to use item to list. And I'm going to call this items to keep. And I'm going to put, let's see, my var here. And we're going to click OK. Now, since I've started a list, I want to make sure I keep everything nice and clean. And let me see here. And I think that is it. So let's do a set command down here. I'm just going to set var. Nothing. And since we're already on the page, let's go ahead and save this. You can see here I've already done it once. So let's go. That's my second version. So I'm going to open up debugger here. I'm just going to go ahead and clear out the variables here. Now I'm going to run it. And now you can see it scraped everything. And it put the text that was in between the left side of text and the right side of text into a list. And yes, I could have used the page scrape, but the page scrape, you saw what it would do. In fact, or did we see that? So let me create a set here, and I'll show you the page scrape. And browser functions. And left side. copy, paste, right side, copy, paste. We're gonna okay that, open up our debugger, and we're just gonna run it once. And you can see what the page scrape actually grabbed. Now, looking at this data, we would still have to do some work to it to clean up the spaces. But you can also see how I was able to, I wouldn't have to do that doing this. So there's definitely advantages and disadvantages with using the page scrape versus the scrape attribute. Scrape attribute, you have more flexibility. And so with the scrape attribute, you can use regex in here. And so you can see how I was able to focus on each of the 15 lines, and I was able to build a list. So that's it in a nutshell on how you would use regex with a scrape attribute. And I hope you liked this video. I hope it was helpful. If it was, I would greatly appreciate it if you would like it down below. And if you like the videos that I create on this channel, I would appreciate it also if you would subscribe and click the bell notification, so the next time I put up a video like this one, you'll get a short notification that there's a new video that you may want to check out. So anyway, thank you for your time, and we'll see you in the next video.